have nothing in your house that you do not know to be useful or believe to be beautiful. William Morris. The world is too much with us. It certainly is. So many of us having more things than we could ever need. Clothes we've never worn or haven't worn in ages. CDs, cassette tapes, records, games, consoles, phones and miscellaneous cost tech devices, books we've read and won't read again, magazines with articles we're going to read but actually never get around to, trinkets, ornaments and family heirlooms left behind by past generations, gifts you've never liked, board games you no longer play, things that need cleaning or repair before you can use them again. Pots, pans, utensils, kit and equipment you just don't use. Not a hoarder, you're just a normal person with lots of stuff. Do you think your home is too small or you need more storage space? It's unlikely. What's more likely is that you just have too much stuff. A bigger home and more storage space, cupboards, wardrobes, chests, storage boxes, etc. Or just give you more reasons to accumulate and keep stuff. Get stuff, buy stuff, keep it, get more of it. Keep that too. When did this become normal? Having too much stuff is the new normal. 3/4 of the families had stopped using their garage to park their cars. They had too much stuff crammed in to make way for rejected furniture and cascading bins, and boxes of mostly forgotten household goods. The families had enough food to survive all manner of disasters. 47% had second fridges. A few of the families had more TVs than people. The study found that average 10-year-old owns 238 toys, but parents estimated that their children play with just 12 favorite, 5% on a daily basis. The study of 3,000 parents also revealed that more than half thought their children ended up playing with the same toys in and day out because they had too many to choose from. They have too much stuff. We have too much stuff. Stuff that takes up space, thought, energy and time or money without providing any real benefit. Why do we acquire more than we need? These are several reasons why we acquire more than we think we need to. For future use, just in case. Even if we don't need it now, many of us buy and keep hold of things thinking, I might need this someday to improve our lives. We believe that if we buy this, that, or the other, we'll have more fun and be more fun. We'll know more, be better entertained, look better, feel better, and so on. As mementos and souvenirs, we buy small and relatively inexpensive things. Reminders of a place visited, an occasion, an achievement. We think we need it. Of course we know that buying things we never use is a waste of money. But so often we don't know if something is necessary until after we buy it. And it sits in a cupboard, wardrobe, shed, etc. untouched for months or even years. To solve problems. How to slice and dice, chop and peel? It turns out every known item of food has at least one tool to help you deal with it. A bagel slicer, pizza slicer, pastry cutters, vegetable peeler, garlic press, roast cutting tongs, a rice maker, vegetable steamer, and of course a knife cleaning clip. The list is endless. But actually there's not much you need in the kitchen to prepare and cook food. Some pots and pans, a couple of sharp kitchen knives, and a few other tools. What you don't need is a specialized tool to slice your tomatoes, another one for boiled eggs, and another one to slice avocados. Do you? All this stuff is proving, in many ways, to be bad for the planet and bad for people. We are facing a clutter crisis. Some of us know we own too much stuff. Some of us don't. Either way, we feel ruined and burdened by our clutter. Clutter drains our time and energy and takes up space. Drawers don't close. Cupboards are jammed full and shelves are filled from top to bottom. We often can't see what to wear for all our clothes. Physical clutter leads to mental clutter, making it harder to think straight. Clutter competes for your attention. It keeps you aware that there is always something else that needs to be done. To be cleaned, cleared, and put away. To be fixed, or folded, or found. We get frustrated when we can't find something. Phones, keys, and paperwork amongst all our stuff. It's disheartening and stressful. The things you're afraid to let go make a fear-based clutter. In contrast, hope-based clutter is all the things you hold on to in the hope that someday you will get around to using, reading, wearing, etc. Fears and hopes about the future stop us from letting go. So do memories from the past. Attempts to discard things often bring up emotions that are difficult to deal with. Sadness, worry, fear, unfulfilled hopes. Avoiding these emotions can be a reason to avoid a clear out. Remember what your house is for. Is it a place for you to enjoy and to live in joyfully? Or is it for you to store items that feel like a crime to get rid of? Sheila Chandra. Hope-based clutter. Unused sports equipment, clothes no longer worn, books not read, and so on. Just so I was to remind you of what you still haven't got around to doing, reading, wearing, etc. Live in the present, free up space in your home for something you need, want or want to do now. Whatever it is that you're holding on to, ask yourself why. Identify and acknowledge the feelings and emotions that arise. Then focus on what you have to gain by clearing your clutter. Focus on the benefits. Slow down and enjoy life. It's not only the scenery you miss by going too fast. You also miss the sense of where you're going and why. Eddie Cantor. Benefits of decluttering your commitments. Just as there are benefits to decluttering your home, there are benefits to decluttering your commitments. Which of these benefits to letting go of one or more of your commitments appeals to you? I'll feel less stressed, pressured, burdened, and put upon. I no longer waste my time worrying about what I feel I ought to do or I should do, and start focusing on the things I want to do. I'll have more time, energy, and money for the commitments I choose to keep, the things I really want to do, that I enjoy and care about. Think about your values, what's important to you, and add some words. Here are some examples. Time with family, time with friends, your physical health, your mental health, time for your current interests and hobbies, time to learn new skills and knowledge, time to do absolutely nothing, to be quiet, calm and relax. What relationships, work, activities, etc. are most important to you? Think about which of these you enjoy doing, which of these are in line with your values. What's important to you? Learn to say no. This is a key skill to help declutter your time and simplify your life. If you can't say no to other people, you'll find yourself taking on too much. Give just one reason. You only need one genuine reason for saying no. Just say what you need to say. Set limits. Decide how many commitments and obligations are enough in any one day, week or month. Instead of trying to cram too much into every day, leave room between commitments. This book was Declutter Your Life by Kill Hassan. Clutter competes your attention. Yeah, it certainly is. The first thing I do whenever I have ideas, I just write it down. If it's kind of affirmation, I write a note on small post-it and I put it on my monitor. So I don't think, what was I thinking? That was a good idea. It's because I don't want to spend my energy to try to memorize it. Once you write down, you're free. You don't have to memorize it. It's just there, physically. And also, to-do list as well. Daily tasks I put onto application called Habitica. It's really cute. It's kind of gamified app, so you can raise your characters. It's like a role-playing game. I don't use full function, but I just like sometimes I buy clothes, cute clothes for my character. Mostly I don't touch it. I just like it because I thought it was the best to-do list for me. I just walked. I tried like simple looking to-do list, Microsoft to-do list, Evernote. For to-do list, I somehow using like almost 2 years Habitica, so it just works for me. I really recommend you to use Planner or Anyst to-do list. It just frees up your space in your head. You don't really have to memorize anything. Mostly I have the same routine, but some things happen all the time. I just simply add with the date so I can see the deadline. And then I just check once a day and I don't think about it. I mean, I think it's good to try to memorize your family phone numbers, something useful information, but just some ideas that you won't need it in the future. I think it's good to write down and just forget about it. Life is so much easier. Thanks for listening. Have a calm and peaceful day.